Okay.
If you're joining me,
good morning.
Let me know how the music is for ya. Get my camera set up here. Make sure you can see. I'm just kind of on a few minutes late, so wait to see who's here and then we'll get started. Colleen. Yes, I need the movement too. Hey, Debbie. Can you guys hear the music all right? Is it too loud, too soft? Okay, good. I can turn it up a bit. Okay, good. The songs will be okay. Okay. Move the music closer. If my speaker starts to die, then I'll plug it back in. So we're gonna get started, since this is a few minutes after, this morning in child's pose, or a meditative seat if you prefer. Making sure you can see my whole mat here. Beginning to lengthen that breath, the inhales and the exhales. Maybe finding the things to be grateful for, the sunshine yesterday, maybe. I know I was out there most of the day. Maybe moving to that Ujjayi breath as you build that internal heat. Maybe just starting to come to that breath. You won't be here for too long. It's a shorter class. Take maybe three more deep inhales and exhales. Either in your child's pose or in your meditative seat. Adjust the music real quick. From your child's pose or your meditative seat, we're just gonna set right up into that hero's pose. If you're in child's pose, just lift your head. Come to sit back on the shins or the heels here, and I'll face you guys. Just taking some side bends from here, planting the right hand at inhales. You lift the left up and over, and breathe here into the side body. Switching sides, left hand will come down, right comes up and over. Stretching all the way across that side body. And from here, you can flow through these side stretches if you want. Just kind of waking up the body here. You can deepen this by bending the elbow or twisting the chest to the floor. Again, finding movement here that feels good for you. That's all I'll encourage you to do throughout the class. Adding in movement whenever you need it. Taking out anything that doesn't serve you. One more right, one more left. And we'll come back to tabletop and meet there. From here, beginning to move through some of those cats and cows. Again, taking whatever movement you'd like here. You'd like this to turn into hip circles, if that feels good this morning, or C shapes. Go ahead and take those. Just moving with your breath. You need to wake up through the spine. Nice. And from here, feet back in that neutral tabletop position, moving through a little spinal balance flow here. So we inhale, lift the right hand out, long, left leg comes out behind us. Really first getting long here, reaching from fingertips to toes. Inhale here, exhale as you crunch it in, elbow meets knee. Inhale, back and out. From here, come to that awkward pose as the left leg comes out to the left and the right arm comes out to the right. Hold here for a breath. Come back to center, crunch it in. Repeat this, so spinal balance, crunch. Opposite leg and arm out. Through center, crunch it in. And take a few of these at the rhythm and measure of your own breath. Focusing on this core here, or just starting off strong with these core movements. Take maybe one more. And then from here, we'll plant that right hand down, keeping the left leg extended. From here, we'll take a few little bird push-ups as we tap the chin down, keeping those elbows tugged into the ribs, just like we would in our chaturanga. Taking maybe three or five of these little prep push-ups here, helping us build up our chaturanga strength. Nice. After that last one, that left leg, we'll come back down. Take a little rest off of our wrists here. And sit back in a child's. Maybe rotate the wrist. Or what I like to do is come to tabletop. Turn the palms around, fingertips facing me. Kind of just rock back and forth here. Stretching out through those wrists. Rocking back and forth, maybe even turning the palms down this way. Little rock here. Nice. Meet right back in that neutral tabletop position. And then we'll switch sides. Left hand extends out long this time. And right foot. Take a minute here. Really extend and reach. Get long. As you exhale, elbow meets knee, crunching underneath. Inhale, you come back out. Left hand this time extends up to the left, right foot out to the right here. So here we strong here. Back to center. Crunch it in. Again, move through a few of these. The measure of your own breath. Steady, we've kept our eye clear from the exit sign. Knowing the feel can feel like dawn. After that last one. Back through center, that left hand will plant back down. That right leg will stay extended, keeping that foot flexed so hips are square. Just get a few little push-ups here. Kind of fun. Take three, take five, take one. After that last one, bringing that leg back down. Warming up here however you need to. Maybe bending into one knee and the other. Maybe shaking the head out yes and no. New breaths here. And from here, we're going to begin to walk the hands up, feet up towards the hands, and then come to the outside of the hands here. So we're in our malasana. Here, just you guys. Taking a minute here, maybe we invite in a little movement here, a little sway. We'll take a twist while we're here, so that right hand plant in the middle of our feet, left hand will come up for a twist. There's always a bind here if you'd like, if you're ready for it. Exhale, switch sides. Nice. From here, let's reach those hands out long in front of us, palms face each other. And then from here, we'll fold, just that wide-legged forward fold. And we'll flow through these movements. So that malasana, open up for that wide-legged forward fold. And flow through a few of these. center of your own breath. Just open up through the hamstrings. After that last one, you need to rise up nice and slow. We're only at one vertebrae at a time here. Head is the last thing to lift. Inhale, we'll lift those arms up overhead. Right hand will grab that left wrist as we begin to bend over. We're going to swing all the way down in these big circles here. And then we'll switch sides, coming towards the left, coming all the way down. Take a few of these. You have to measure your own breath. Maybe you linger down the bottom, swing side to side. Waking up the whole body. One more each way. And then from here, release those hands. Begin to heel toe those feet together. As we're in our Tadasana. Take a big inhale and exhale here. Top of our mat. Inhale, lifts those hands up overhead. As we exhale, we'll fold in for our first forward fold. So warm up as you need, maybe bending into one leg and then the other. And then inhale, we'll lift us up halfway. Exhale, those hands will plant. We'll step back for our first plank pose. Just hold in here first for a few breaths. Building up that heat. Core is strong. As you exhale, take that chaturanga and hold here if you can. If you're having trouble holding here and the belly's coming down to the ground, that's a sign that we need to come to our knees. This is fine, just holding right here, building up that strength. A few more breaths here. All right, inhale for your cobra or your up dog. Nice, and exhale, downward facing dog. And breathe. Here, real quick. How are you guys doing? Okay, good. All right, from your downward facing dog, inhale, let's lift that right leg up. Warming it up here. Maybe you want some of those big hip circles here. Maybe it's just a bend, twist, and open. Just warming up. We'll add on next time. Set that right foot down, same on the left. Open up here, let's take hip circles. I like to do that to warm up. Or just bend, twist, and open. And to the left foot from here, walking or taking that hop up to the front of the mat. Landing lightly, inhale, lifts you up halfway. Exhale, fold you in. Inhale, we rise all the way up. Hands come to prayer. Let's add on a side bend from here. Inhale, side bend to the right. Come back through the center. Exhale, over side bend to the left. Back through center. Exhale, fold you in. Swan dive forward. Inhale, lift you up, flat back. Exhale, plant the hands. Step, or if you're ready, hop back to your plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale for that cobra or up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. And right from here, a little extra challenge to try. Lift that right leg up. Three-legged dog. Bend the right knee. All right, there's things you can do from here. You can just prop up onto these cupcake or Spider-Man fingers here with the left hand. Or you can begin to extend that left hand and see if you've got balance here. Maybe that left hand can find that right foot. Sometimes I can't, some days I can't. If you've got the foot, maybe you can press into it as you would in a dancer's pose. Grabbing that tail, just something fun and different to play with. Exhale, brings that right foot back down. Try the same thing on the left. Left leg comes up. And maybe you just start with propping up onto those fingertips to feel that balance. Maybe you just extend that hand. Maybe it comes to meet that foot and you press the foot into the hand. Get a little bit of lift here through the chest. Nice, exhale, release. From here, step, hop, or float back up to the top of the mat. Inhale, lifts you halfway. Exhale, fold you in. Inhale, lifts you all the way up. Exhale, hands come to center. We'll start our second flow. Inhale, lift those arms up overhead. Exhale, fold you in. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, hands plant, step, hop, or float to the back of your mat. And roll through your vinyasa. Meeting a downward facing dog. Take a few breaths here. Wipe off my mat, hugging me. From here, we're going to once again lift up that right leg, three-legged dog. This first movement is a little bit different, so we'll break it down slow the first time. So from here, begin to bend, twist, and open. We're going to flip that dog. Inhale, open up for Wild Thing. Take a breath here. From here, we're going to lower down to our seats, just as so. And we're going to begin to bring the feet together into the squat pose. And then help ourselves right up off to the right side of our mat here. So we can either be in a malasana or we can be in this closed knee squat here. From here, we're going to bring both our hands over to the back side of our mat. Planting them here almost like we're going to go into a crow pose. Except we're going to hop to the back of our mat with our right foot back and press it. So we'll play with it a few times. Bring both the hands over towards the mat. Hop, right foot's gonna come back for a crescent. So you can play with that a few times before we add it in. Hop, as you would hop up, maybe for a handstand. Hands come over, hop, right foot comes back. Landing lightly, we open up for a crescent pose. Inhale, get nice and tall here, exhale to sink in. Then we're gonna T-twist. Right hand comes up front, left hand is behind. Reverse, revolve. From here, we're coming all the way up, switching those hands into marcher's pose. Right knee comes in. Exhale from here, we're sweeping those arms back for airplane or warrior three. Exhale, opening up for warrior two. Take a minute to sink in here. We'll flow through this faster next time. From here, we're coming to Skandasana, opposite side, which would be the front of our mat. And we'll add in more here later. For now, you can just stay in the Skandasana, or you can flow it back and forth if you want a little tiger in the grass action. Eventually, we're coming all the way to that back mat. Opening up here for a dragonfly twist. So right hand is down, left hand is up. Probably know where we're going from here. Opening up for that side plank. Right hand's down, left hand's up. Exhale, coming back to plank. Lowering slow. Rolling through your vinyasa. Medium and downward facing dog. I feel like I need to adjust the camera. Okay, we're good. All right, taking it on the opposite side. We're in a downward facing dog. Inhale, lifts the left leg up. Begin to bend, twist, and open as we flip that dog. Inhale, open up for that Wild Thing. Taking a minute to open up through the heart space and then come to the seat. Same thing here. Hands can come behind for support if you need as you rock up. For either that wide leg in Malasana or knees can be closed here. I kind of like to keep them closed here. Both hands plant over to the front of the mat, just like we're prepping for side throw. Think about that. As you press, you're gonna hop, and left foot's gonna come back this time for your pressing. Maybe take just a few hops here to kind of play with that. Trying to land nice and light, lightly there. Nice. After that, we'll be up in that crescent. In, exhale to sink in here. And then we'll take that T twist. Reverse, revolved. We'll we're coming all the way up for marchers. Left knee comes into the chest this time. You can take this marching motion with the arms if you like. Extend for airplane or warrior three. Exhale as we open up for that warrior two. Take a breath here. And then we're coming to Skandasana, the opposite side of the mat. And choosing stillness here, or if you'd like a little flow back and forth. Eventually, we're all coming back. Up towards the front of the mat now. Pivoting on those feet. Left hand plants, right hand opens up for dragonfly twist. And then taking your side plank from here. Snapping those feet. Pressing this right hip up to the sky. Exhale for your plank. Take your vinyasa. Take a few breaths in your downward facing dog. Or pressing to child if you need for a few breaths. And then we'll take that flow through again. Maybe a little bit faster this time, and we'll add in. On your next inhale, lift that right leg up. This time, draw it in towards the right armpit. Drag it down to the right wrist, over to the left wrist, up to the left armpit. So we're kind of making this box shape here. Take maybe 3 or 5 of these. Get a little core and strength work here. After that last time, inhale, lifts out. Right leg back and up. Exhale as you flip that dog. Inhale for that wild thing, letting the heart shine out. Coming to a seat. Stepping that left foot up, rising up into that squat. Ready to take that hop. Maybe you want one, maybe you want two. Eventually meeting in that crescent. Open up, T-twist. Reverse revolve. Ready, we're coming all the way up to marchers. Out for airplane. Open up for warrior two. Coming to the back of the mat for Skandasana. So from here you can flow if you'd like, or you can take a little side stretch here. Left hand comes to that right heel, and we reach over. Maybe we grab that foot and turn the chest towards the sky. Eventually we're coming all the way back, pivoting on the feet. Opening up for that dragonfly twist. Options here, if you want to grab that toe and then open up for your side flip, go ahead and do that. Whatever variation you'd like. Maybe that leg stays lifted as you take your vinyasa. Take 3 breaths in your downward facing dog. All right. From here, inhale, lift the left leg up. Take those knee squeezes as we bring it to the left armpit, drag it down to the left wrist, over to the right wrist, up to the right armpit, making this square here. Taking 3, taking 5, skipping this if you want. After that last one, lifting the left leg, back and up, bend, twist, and open, lift your dog. Coming to a seat, stepping those feet together. It's fine, it's okay to be off our mats. Bringing the hands back over, taking those hops. One or more if you'd like. That left foot is coming back. Inhale, we rise up for that crescent. Exhale, T-twist. Inhale, reverse revolve. Stepping up for that marcher's pose. Airplane. You can do whatever you want with your arms. You can switch it up each time if you'd like. From here, opening up for that warrior two.
Guys, sweating yet? I'm sweaty. Coming back to that Skandasana. Either flowing through this or taking that side stretch here. Right hand comes to that left ankle. As you reach over, maybe you find that foot and rotate that chest to the sky. I love this stretch. All right, we'll all meet back up. Moving on that back foot, dragonfly twist. Taking those peace fingers if you'd like the challenge. Binding up the toes, opening up from here. Maybe you want to take a few flows here up and down. Maybe that leg stays lifted as you take that vinyasa. Nice. Take three breaths in downward facing dog or child. And go through that flow just one more time. We'll be back in downward facing dog. Inhale, lift the right leg up. Exhale, maybe just make one box shape here. Take one here. You can always add on more if you'd like. Inhale, lift that leg back up. Flip your dog. Exhale, drops the seat. If you guys have this flow, take it on your own. Faster or slower if you'd like. Coming up to that squat. Taking those hops, maybe these turn into handstand things here. You add on whatever you like. Now, right foot is going to step back. We're going to come off to a crescent. T-twist. Reverse revolve. Stepping up for that marchers. Maybe this time the leg extends. You do whatever you want here with the leg. Reaching back for that airplane. And opening up for warrior two. Coming back to that Skandasana. If you'd like something different here, you can bind. Reaching for the wrist behind. Point and flex the foot. Lots of options. Eventually we're all coming to the back of the mat, pivoting on the back foot, right hand plant, left hand open. You take whatever version of side plank that you'd like to do. And you roll through your vinyasa. Take a few breaths in your downward facing dog. Go through the left side one last time. Lifting the left leg up, making that box shape. Once, maybe twice, if you want a little more. Inhale, lift that left leg, and we flip our dog. Coming to a seat. Feet will meet however they'd like to meet. We take that hop back to the mat. Left foot is coming back this time. Inhale, lift those arms up. Exhale, T-twist. Reverse revolve. Coming up to marchers. Maybe you want to extend and bend that leg. Airplane. And stepping lightly back for your last warrior or two. Skandasana. And take whatever variation you'd like here. Bind, sway, take a twist. And meet back, pivoting on those feet. Open up, dragonfly twist. Maybe grab that toe, maybe you just stack, maybe that knee drops. And we meet in that plank. Take your vinyasa. Press back to a child's pose here. Come into your restorative place from here. If child's pose works, you can stay there if you'd rather. And hero's pose, hand to heart, hand to belly. If we haven't done any inversions, if headstand is in your practice, go ahead and take a few breaths in headstand.
begin to come down. Take a counter pose, do a bit of headstand, and child's pose or rabbit. And we will meet however you'd like to make your way there in downward facing dog. You want to roll through a cat and a cow, maybe. And lifting those hips high. From here, we'll inhale, lift the right leg high to the sky. Exhale, as we draw it up between the hands, planting the right foot. We're going to drop that back left knee. Inhale, reaching up for our kneeling crescent. From here, we're going to take that same knee twist as we did when we were in our crescent. Arms come back up through center. We're going to drop that left hand back to the left heel. So we're opening up for this kneeling like half camel. Feels so good. Palm faces down towards the floor. Open the heart space. Nice. Exhale, both hands come to surround that front foot. As we begin to wiggle that foot out, pressing back for half splits. Taking a minute here to kind of lengthen and sink in. IT band stretch that just feels so juicy to me. You're going to shake this right foot, move it over towards the left corner of our mat. Both hands are going to walk towards the right of that leg, the outside of it, and then you can bend in from here if you'd like. You can even walk those hands out further towards the right and then bend in, feeling it all along the back of the leg in the IT band. Just discovered this the other day. It feels so good. Few breaths here. We'll move that foot back through center. Pressing into the foot. Bending the knee. Opening up for one more of those half camels because it feels so good. From here, both hands will come to surround that front foot. Maybe cup taking those fingers. Propping up those back toes. We're going to step up for a low crescent. And then from here, I'll give you two options. You can either hop up to a standing split and work with your standing splits in your handstands, or you can just drag that back foot up, railroad track those feet, and fold in for your waterfall. And with your waterfall, there's options as well. Hands can come here, you can come in reverse prayer behind your back, and fold in, making it extra balancey. If you're in standing splits, you can work on that balance with one hand around the ankle, maybe both. Take some handstand kicks if you'd like from here. Either way, we're going to step that left foot up to meet the right at the top of the mat. Inhale, lift up halfway. Exhale, we'll fold in. Inhale, we'll rise up. Hands come through to heart center. That foot will be on the other side. Inhale, lift those arms up overhead. Exhale, swan, dive forward. Inhale, halfway, plant those hands, step, hop or float back. Take a vinyasa, you can skip it, and meet us right back in downward facing dog. Once you're here, inhale, lift the left leg this time. Exhale, draw in and up, dropping onto that back right knee. Rising up for kneeling crescent. Taking a few breaths here to get tall and settle in. And then we'll take that T twist. Left hand comes behind, right is up front. Going back through center, taking that half camel. Right hand's going to drop back towards that right thigh or heel if you can reach it. And open up. Exhale to come back through center. Hands surround that front left foot. Shimmy that foot out for half splits. Taking a few breaths here, really lengthen out the spine and then sink in. And then from here, moving that left heel over towards the right corner of the mat, bringing both hands to the outside, that left foot. and then bowing in. It's probably only gonna be a little bow here. It doesn't take much to feel that. The IT band, the back of the leg. Okay, so then we'll come back. Bringing that foot back through center. Landing the foot. Rising back up with that kneeling crescent and taking one more half camel stretch. Breathe here. And then exhale, hands come. Taking those fingers if you'd like, pressing that back leg straight. And from here again, you have that choice to play with your standing splits and the balance and handstand kicks, or you can just drag that right foot up, coming into your waterfall. Hands, if you can't get the reverse prayer, you can grab opposite elbows here. Think about shining your heart forward here, and then let the head fall in. From here, I'm gonna step that right foot up to meet the left. Fold in. Inhale, lift halfway. Fold in once more. We'll rise all the way up to the top. Hands come through center. Grab a quick drink of water. We'll go through that flow one more time. Meet standing at the top of our mat. Inhale, lift those hands up high. Exhale, we fold. Inhale, lift you halfway. Step, hop, or float to the back of the mat. Take your vinyasa or skip it. Knee back in downward facing dog. Inhale, lift the right leg. Exhale, steps it up in between the hands, dropping the back knee. Rising up for that kneeling crescent. Take that T twist. Back through center. Take that half camel stretch. Exhale, coming back through center. Half splits. If you want to add in full splits here, it'd be a great time to work on a full splits practice. Or you can just keep the half splits and that IT band stretch. Either way, we're both gonna meet. We're all gonna be back in that kneeling crescent pose. Take one more half camel. And then options from here. Straighten that back leg into crescent. You can always just step up if you'd like. Or you can take a waterfall pose with any arm variation you'd like here. Or you can work on your standing splits and your handstand hops. Whatever you'd like. You're gonna be back standing at the front of our mat. And we'll fold in. Eventually we'll all rise up once more. Inhale, lift the hands up overhead. Exhale, hands come to heart center. We got one more side. Those hands up, exhale, fold in. Inhale, you rise up halfway, step, hop, or float to the back of the mat. Take your vinyasa or skip it, meet back in downward facing dog. Inhale, left leg comes up high. Exhales, we plant it in between the hands. Rising up. Crescent. T-twist. Back through center. Half camel. Back through center. Hands surround that front left foot. Half splits. And that IT band stretch here. Or playing with a full splits practice here. We'll all meet back. And that's your own crescent. We'll take one more. Our last half camel. Really reach. Stretch. Back through center, and then straighten that back leg, playing with your standing splits here, or taking that waterfall stretch. One last time. And we'll step
Step that right foot up to meet the left. Inhale, rise up halfway, and we'll fold in. Rising all the way up. Taking our last vinyasa here. Inhale, hands up, exhale, we fold in. Lift up halfway, step up or float, back to a plank. We're gonna lower all the way down to our belly here. And once you get there, just taking a minute to rest either the forehead down or the opposite cheek, one cheek or the other, onto the mat or the hands. Taking a few back bends from here. So on your next inhale, arms are going to come to cactus, those goal post arms. Inhale, you rise up here. You can either hold here or you can flow this out as you lift legs and arms, lowering up and down. Or if you'd like, you can swim the hands here, forward and back. Here, when you're ready, the hands will come behind. Interlace the fingers. Pull those knuckles down. As you inhale, chest lifts, feet can lift. Take a few breaths lifted here. Exhale, release down to the ground. Take a few breaths lowered. Take one more back bend here. Full bow isn't in your practice, you can take either one of those back bends that we just did. Bending the knees, reaching behind for the ankles, the tops of the feet. Inhale as you again lift the chest, lift the heart, really pressing those feet or those ankles into the hands here. Maybe you rock back and forth here with a breath. Sludging out of the tummy. Taking just a few more breaths here. And exhale, release the legs, release the hands, and rest for a few breaths. I'm living for the right now. Hands come underneath the shoulders, pressing back up, swinging the legs all the way around, out in front of us here. Just contouring those back bends real quick with a forward fold, flexing through the feet. Inhale, lift the hands up. Exhale, fold in here. Again, taking movement here if you like. I kind of like to shimmy my shoulders in. Point and flex the feet here. Just a few more breaths here. Rise up nice and slow here. We're going to lower all the way down onto our back from here. From here, we'll extend those feet up. Flexing those feet. We're going to take supine pigeon from here. Planting the left foot down. Right foot comes across over the top of that left knee. And then drawing that left knee in, reaching through that keyhole, maybe grabbing behind the thigh here. Maybe that leg extends, you circle the ankle. Just taking a few breaths here, releasing through the hip space. And then next exhale, we'll drop towards the left, open the arms up into T, taking a twist here. Gaze can look out over the opposite shoulder. Breathe into this twist here. And here we'll come back through center. We take a few windshield wipers here with the legs, letting the knees fall to the left and the right. And then we'll switch sides.
That right foot will plant, left foot will cross over the right. Drawing in that right leg. Maybe the leg extends, we circle the ankle. Maybe take that hand and gently press open here for a deeper stretch. And then we'll let those feet drop over to the right this time for a twist. One more breath here. Coming back through center. Releasing that leg. Extending the legs up high once again. If you're fine here in candlestick, just stay in here. If you'd like a little bit more to end your practice, you can reach up for that shoulder stand. Give an inversion in here. Start the day. Turn shoulder stand. You can let those legs extend long for plow pose. Knees can drop around the ears for ear pressure pose. Wherever you are, we're all going to meet back in that candlestick pose. Letting the legs fall down nice and slow and controlled here. And then we'll draw the knees up into the chest, wrapping our arms around the shins, drawing the elbows up towards the knees, squeezing ourselves into this tight little ball here. Inhale, hold, and then exhale, release it all down. Letting the feet fall out to the bottom corners of the mat. Moving into our final resting pose. I love this song. Let the eyes fall shut here and dim the lights. Taking your well-deserved yoga rest.
Nothing.
beginning to bring your awareness back to the body, back to the breath. Wiggling fingers and toes as you're ready. Taking a nice big good morning stretch as you extend those hands up overhead, feet long. Nice big inhale, hold at the top, and exhale, release. Drawing those knees into the chest, rolling into fetal or rocking all the way up. Leaning back in a nice easy seat at the top of the mat. Hands and drop. Heart center, bowing in here with gratitude. Gratitude for this practice, for this community we can still share. Inhale, lifts the chin, lifts the heart. Thank you so much for sharing your practice here with me this morning. The love, the light, the joy, and the peace that is within me sees, honors, and so humbly bows before the same love, light, joy, and peace within each and every one of you. Namaste.